Don't you just want to say, wow, what God can do? What God can do? Can you feel the foundations of this city starting to rock? Can you feel the bedrock underneath starting to crack as if God is finally able to do with us what he's been wanting to do for so many years? For so many years he's been wanting to do it. See, I'm convinced that when the people of God come together and they worship and they say and they bow before God and they say, God, we can't do it without you. When we say, God, we can't do it without you, is when he steps in and he does it for us. So first and foremost, I want to tell you, I want to start in my heart, and I just want to pray, and I want to repent of God for favoritism that I've shown, for partiality that I've shown, that a lack of appreciation for other beautiful people that I've shown. And I'm willing, if you're willing, to just pray a quick prayer and just ask God to forgive us. Heavenly Father, we ask you, we repent before you. We ask you to forgive us, God, our iniquity. Before we can change someone else, we ask you to change us. And by changing us, we will change the world. And we thank you in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Hallelujah. I got to tell you, but the first step in everything is the word of God. So I'm going to read some word to you this morning. So God created mankind in his own image. In the image of God, he created them, male and female. He created them. And it's a simple message, and that is we are all one. We are all created in the image of God, and therefore we're all beautiful. Whatever color or stripe you are, you're beautiful to God, and we should be beautiful to one another. So as we go to our Heavenly Father, remember, he didn't ask you for permission to make your brother or your sister. He didn't ask you for permission. He just said, love the beautiful people that I've made. So let's give God a praise this morning and just thank him for being so gracious and so loving and so wonderful and so mighty in all of our lives in Jesus' name.